I'm sure you've seen the headlines. The Great Barrier Reef has lost more coral than ever before. Now, when you add to this that we lost half the coral since the mid-60s, about half the coral since the mid-80s, devastated, 40% loss, was it, in 2016, similar in 2017, 2020, 2022, 2024, I calculate we should now have minus 320% of coral, or something like that. But let's actually have a look at the real data to see what the coral is actually like in 2025. You see in this graph, it actually doesn't look too bad, does it? There has been a drop. Yes, there has been a drop. And you can doubtless say that there's a whole lot of people that are ecstatic because the coral has dropped, but it's dropped from record amounts. In fact, the last 5 years, including this year, have all been higher, at least the raw amount, have all been higher than any of the previous 30-odd or 35 years of data. So not really all that bad, actually, is it? Now, I should say one thing about this graph. We're using the data here. I've actually collated this. From the data collected by the Australian Institute of Marine Science, they survey about 100 reefs each year of the 3,000 reefs of the GBR. And I've got to say, they do a remarkable job. It's a huge effort. But I have a criticism. I do this every year. They never plot this graph that I'm showing you here. They only ever plot the results from three of the subregions of the Great Barrier Reef, and they never put that together to form the average amount of coral on the Great Barrier Reef for the whole Great Barrier Reef, which is what everybody wants to know. So that graph I showed you, you will only find from Reef Rebels. Now, when I said that they never do this, well, actually, that's not true. They used to, up to 2017, they used to plot the Great Barrier Reef aggregate. And when you actually look at that data, you can see that's when the reef suddenly started to get an awful lot of coral and it became more and more embarrassing. I'd never say that that was the reason why they stopped collating this data. But it's actually very important because if you don't see this graph, you don't actually get a true impression of how good the reef is over the whole thing. And of course, the data on the reef is used to depress a whole bunch of school children that the world is ending. But I've got to say, things are looking up. I noticed there was a new remarkable report come out from the Department of Energy in the US looking at the whole climate change thing. And they mentioned the Great Barrier Reef, actually, and in what good state it actually is. So we are getting the word out there that the reef is wonderful. Yes, it goes through peaks and troughs. It always has done, but the reef is wonderful. Come and visit it if you ever get a chance. North Queensland's the best place on earth, and the Great Barrier Reef and the rainforest up here is well worth a visit, and it's great.